Hello friends, I Anil Sajnani welcome you to my video lecture. Topic of discussion is Introduction to Central Processing Unit. The reference is chapter Central Processing Unit from the book Computer System Architecture by M. Morris Mano. Friends, the main function of computer is data processing, and data processing in computers happens in the CPU. How CPU does the data processing, or in other words, who gets this job done from the CPU? It is the instruction who gets this job done from the CPU. Let us understand how. If we need to add two numbers, it is the instruction which provides two operands or data to the CPU. Then it is the instruction which tells the CPU that add operation is to be performed on these two operands which are received by the CPU. This can be achieved through one instruction. CPU may use two instructions or more depending upon the hardware used. CPU consists of three main parts: control unit, internal register sets, and ALU, that is arithmetic logic unit. The function of ALU is to perform all arithmetic and logic operations. Internal registers are used to store intermediate results. And control unit manages or controls the transfer of data from the registers to the ALU and transfers of intermediate results from ALU to registers. Now we need to understand why registers are required inside the CPU when already RAM is there in the computers. CPU can always refer data from and to the RAM. First of all, let me explain the meaning of intermediate result. In the computer architecture we are discussing, CPU performs operations on two operands or data only. If you are required to add three numbers, first the addition of two numbers will be carried out. The result will be stored in the intermediate register. Then in the two numbers, that is the sum of the first two numbers and the remaining number, will be carried out. Now the answer of why registers, why not RAM? CPU and other components can access the RAM only through its address. In our case, if CPU has to store the intermediate results to the RAM, first CPU will use the address and the pointer of the RAM and store the data. If the data is required again by the CPU, it will again use the address and pointer of the RAM where the intermediate result is stored and get it. In this process, you can notice that each time CPU has to refer memory by its address and pointers. First, this process slows down the CPU operation or inserts unnecessarily delays. On the other hand, if CPU uses alongside registers for intermediate results, the delay of addressing and the pointer is avoided. There are two types of computer architectures. One is RISC, that is reduced instruction set computers, and the another one is CISC, that is complex instruction set computers. Depending upon the instruction formats, type of the addressing mode used in each, the number of instruction sets, and the general organization of the CPU registers. We will discuss RISC and CISC architecture in other lecture videos. On the basis of how programs and data are stored in the memory, two architectures are defined. If the program and data are stored in the same memory, it is non-embedded computer architecture, also called Stored Program Computers, SPC architecture. All desktop computers are example of stored program computers. If the program and data are stored in different memory, it is embedded computer architecture called Harvard computer architecture. Examples are all microcontroller based systems. If you want to be the programmer of the computer in the assembly or machine language, you must know about the register set, memory structure, and the type of data supported by the instruction, and further the function of each instruction of that particular computer hardware, as these may be different for different computer hardwares, that is computer CPU. Thanks for watching this video. Any reviews, comments, suggestions are welcome. More videos are on the way.